Good morning, everyone. This is Dr. Adel Bondok, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. Today, I will talk about the oral cavity and the anatomy of the tongue. Regarding the oral cavity, I will talk about the boundaries, roof, floor, sides, anterior and posterior, then the divisions of the oral cavity proper and the vestibule, and then the contents, the tongue and the teeth, and then the ducts of glands opening into the oral cavity, nerve supply, arterial supply, and lymph drainage. Start by the boundaries of the oral cavity. This is the roof, and the roof is the palate, and the palate is divided into hard palate, anterior 2/3, and the soft palate, posterior 1/3. Then the floor. The floor is the anterior 2/3 of the tongue and the floor of the mouth. Regarding the front and the sides, cheeks and lips. And posteriorly, this is the oropharyngeal isthmus. And this is the oropharynx. Okay? Regarding the divisions of the oral cavity, is divided into oral cavity proper or mouth cavity proper. It lies inside the alveolar arches, okay? Inside the teeth and the gums, okay? And the vestibule, this is the vestibule. It is the space outside the alveolar arches. So oral cavity proper inside the alveolar arches and the vestibule outside the alveolar arches. This is the vestibule. Okay, regarding the glands which open into the oral cavity, the first one, this is the first duct. This is the parotid duct. The parotid duct opens in the vestibule of the mouth opposite the upper second molar tooth. Then this is the second duct, this one, which is the submandibular duct. This submandibular duct opens on each side of the frenulum of the tongue. This is the frenulum of the tongue. And then sublingual ducts from 10 to 12, they open on the sublingual fold, and there are numerous mucous glands. So parotid duct, submandibular duct, sublingual ducts, and the ducts of mucous glands. Regarding the nerve supply of the oral cavity, okay, I will talk about the nerve supply of the roof, the floor, and the cheek. Regarding the roof, the palate, remember, hard palate and soft palate, okay? The palate is supplied by the sphenopalatine ganglion of the maxillary nerve. There are three branches of the sphenopalatine ganglion. This is the first branch. It is the greater palatine nerve, and this is the second branch, lesser palatine nerve, and this is the third branch, nasopalatine nerve. So the palate is supplied by three nerves arising from the sphenopalatine ganglion, greater palatine nerve, lesser palatine nerve, and the nasopalatine nerve. Regarding the floor of the oral cavity, is supplied by the lingual nerve from the mandibular nerve. Regarding the cheek, it's supplied from the buccal branch of the mandibular nerve. The nerve supply of the teeth. We have maxillary teeth and the mandibular teeth. The maxillary teeth are supplied by the maxillary nerve. The mandibular teeth are supplied by the mandibular nerve. So what are the branches of each one? Regarding the maxillary teeth, the anterior superior alveolar nerve supplies the incisors and the canine. Anterior superior alveolar nerve. Then the middle superior alveolar nerve supplies the premolar, and the posterior superior alveolar nerve supplies the three molar teeth. So the maxillary teeth are supplied by the maxillary nerve by the three branches. anterior superior alveolar to the incisors and the canine, middle superior alveolar to the premolar, and the posterior superior alveolar to the molar. Regarding the mandibular teeth, they are supplied by the inferior alveolar branch and its incisive branch. Inferior alveolar nerve and its incisive branch. Regarding the nerve supply of the gingiva, also we have maxillary gingiva and the mandibular gingiva. Maxillary gingiva by the maxillary nerve. Mandibular gingiva by the mandibular nerve. So maxillary gingiva, maxillary nerve, mandibular gingiva by the mandibular nerve. But remember, the gingiva is divided into buccal and lingual. So the buccal surface of the maxillary gingiva is supplied by the three branches of the maxillary nerve: anterior superior alveolar, middle superior alveolar, and the posterior superior alveolar nerves. Okay? The lingual surface of the maxillary gingiva, the lingual surface is supplied by the nasopalatine and the greater palatine nerves. So the maxillary gingiva, buccal and lingual surface. The buccal surface, anterior superior alveolar, middle superior alveolar, and the posterior superior alveolar nerves. And the lingual surface is supplied by the nasopalatine nerve and the greater palatine nerve. Regarding the mandibular gingiva, buccal surface and lingual surface. Buccal surface is supplied by the buccal branch of the mandibular nerve and the mental branch of the inferior alveolar nerve. So buccal and mental nerves. Regarding the lingual surface, it is supplied by the lingual nerve. Regarding the arterial supply of the oral cavity. Again, arterial supply of the oral cavity, we have hard palate, soft palate, lips and cheek, and the floor. Hard palate is supplied by the maxillary artery. Two branches from the maxillary artery. The two branches from the maxillary artery are greater palatine artery and the sphenopalatine artery. So two branches from the maxillary artery, greater palatine and the sphenopalatine branches. Regarding the soft palate, is supplied by three branches: lesser palatine artery from the maxillary artery, ascending palatine artery from the facial artery, and the palatine branches of the ascending pharyngeal artery. Regarding the lips and the cheek, they are supplied by two branches from the facial artery, superior and the inferior labial arteries. Regarding the floor, two branches from the lingual artery, the dorsal lingual arteries and the sublingual artery. So the arterial supply of the oral cavity, hard palate, branches from the maxillary artery, greater palatine and sphenopalatine. Soft palate, branches from the maxillary, branch from the maxillary artery, lesser palatine, branch from the facial artery, ascending palatine, and the branch from the ascending pharyngeal artery. Lips and the cheek from superior labial and inferior labial. The floor of the oral cavity is supplied by the lingual artery. Two branches from the lingual artery, dorsal lingual arteries, and the sublingual artery. Regarding the anatomy of the tongue, what should you know about the tongue? First, the structure of the tongue. The tongue is formed of a sac of mucous membrane filled with muscles. Then, divisions of the tongue. The tongue is divided into two parts: part in the oral cavity and part in the pharynx. So oral part is called the body and the pharyngeal part is called the root. The oral part is the anterior 2/3. The pharyngeal part is the posterior 1/3. Then we'll talk about the muscles. 8 muscles. 4 extrinsic muscles and 4 intrinsic muscles. So muscles of the tongue are 8. 4 extrinsic and 4 intrinsic. Then we'll talk about the blood supply, lingual artery and lingual vein, nerve supply, motor and sensory, and then we'll talk about the lymph drainage of the tongue. So you should know the structure of the tongue, mucous membrane and the muscles. It is divided into two parts. Anterior 2/3 forms the oral part, posterior 1/3 for the pharyngeal part. Okay, start by the mucous membrane of the tongue. This is the mucous membrane. This is the dorsal surface. Dorsal surface of the tongue. It is divided by sulcus terminalis into anterior 2/3 and the posterior 1/3. The anterior two thirds are rough. Why rough? Because it contains lingual papillae. Four lingual papillae. First one is the velate or circumvallate papillae in front of sulcus terminalis and the filiform papillae, and then foliate papillae and the fungiform papillae. So there are four types of papillae on the dorsal surface of the anterior 2/3 of the tongue: velate, filiform, foliate, and the fungiform papillae. They contain, of course, taste buds. Then compare between the oral part and the pharyngeal part of the tongue. Okay, let us compare between the oral and the pharyngeal part. The oral part is the anterior 2/3 of the tongue. The pharyngeal part is the posterior 1/3. The oral part is present in the oral cavity. The pharyngeal part is present in the pharynx. The mucous membrane of the oral part or the mucous membrane of the anterior 2/3 is rough due to the presence of papillae, four types of papillae. The mucous membrane of the pharyngeal part or the posterior 1/3 is smooth due to absence of papillae. The anterior 2/3 of the tongue doesn't contain lymphoid follicles. The posterior 1/3 of the tongue contains lymphoid follicles, and these lymphoid follicles form lingual tonsil. That's why the posterior 1/3 is nodular, but the surface is smooth. Regarding the nerve supply, and the oral part is supplied by the lingual nerve and the corda tympani branch of the facial nerve. The posterior 1/3 is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve. Regarding development, the oral part of the tongue develops from the first pharyngeal arch. The pharyngeal part of the tongue develops from the third pharyngeal arch. That's why the oral part is supplied by the lingual nerve and the pharyngeal part is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve. Regarding the arterial supply, the oral part is supplied by the deep lingual artery and the pharyngeal part is supplied by the dorsal lingual arteries. And these arteries are branches from the lingual artery. Then the ventral surface of the tongue. This is the ventral surface of the tongue. The features on the ventral surface of the tongue in the midline and on each side of the midline. In the midline, this fold is called the frenulum of the tongue. So in the midline, frenulum of the tongue. On each side, we have these vessels and nerve. Okay, deep lingual vein, deep lingual artery, and lingual nerve. Then this fold is called the fimbriated fold. Then this is the sublingual fold and the openings of the sublingual ducts. And then this opening, which is the submandibular duct. Again, this is the ventral surface of the tongue. In the midline, the frenulum of the tongue. On each side of the frenulum, we have these three structures: deep lingual vein, deep lingual artery, and the lingual nerve. Then this is the sublingual fold formed by the sublingual gland and the openings of the sublingual ducts. Then this opening, which is the opening of the submandibular duct. Regarding the muscles of the tongue, 8 muscles, 4 extrinsic and 4 intrinsic muscles. Regarding the extrinsic muscles, the extrinsic muscles are: the first one is the genioglossus. Genioglossus is for protrusion of the tongue. This is the second one. Styloglossus. Styloglossus for retraction of the tongue. Then this one, hyoglossus. And this hyoglossus is for depression of the tongue. And then this muscle is palatoglossus for elevation of the tongue. So the four extrinsic muscles. Genioglossus for protrusion. Styloglossus for retraction. Hyoglossus for depression. Palatoglossus for elevation. Intrinsic muscles run in four directions. Longitudinal, okay, superior and inferior, and vertical, and transverse, and oblique. Again, the extrinsic muscles, the four extrinsic muscles. This is the first one, genioglossus, and the action is protrusion. It arises from the superior genial tubercle. Second one, for retraction. This is the styloglossus, arises from the styloid process. This is the third one, hyoglossus, arises from the hyoid bone for depression. And this one, palatoglossus, arises from the palatine aponeurosis, okay, and this for elevation of the tongue. These muscles, actually all the muscles of the tongue, extrinsic and intrinsic, are supplied by the hypoglossal nerve, except the palatoglossus. This palatoglossus is supplied by the vagus nerve. Regarding the hyoglossus muscle, this is the hyoglossus muscle. You should know the superficial relation and the deep relation. Superficial to the hyoglossus are five structures. These five structures are from above downward. This is the first one, styloglossus muscle. Then the lingual nerve and the submandibular ganglion. Then the deep part of the submandibular gland and the submandibular duct. Then the hypoglossal nerve. And then a branch from the lingual artery is called the suprahyoid artery. Okay? So, the five structures superficial to the hyoglossus are, from above downward, styloglossus, lingual nerve and the submandibular ganglion, deep part of the submandibular gland and the submandibular duct, hypoglossal nerve, and the suprahyoid artery. All these structures are covered by the myelohyoid muscle. This is the myelohyoid muscles. So actually, these structures are deep to the myelohyoid muscle. Regarding the deep relation of the hyoglossus muscle, this is the hyoglossus, this is the sublingual gland. The deep relation, this is the styloid process, okay? Okay, we have one ligament, one artery, one nerve, one muscle, okay, from behind. The ligament is the stylohyoid ligament. The muscle is the stylopharyngeous muscle. The nerve is the glossopharyngeal nerve. And the artery is the second part of the lingual artery. This is the lingual artery. This is the first part. This is the second part. And this is the third part. So four structures run deep to the hyoglossus from behind. Ligament, stylohyoid ligament. Muscle, stylopharyngeus. Nerve, glossopharyngeal nerve. Artery, second part of the lingual artery. From the front, genioglossus muscle. So what are the five structures deep to the hyoglossus muscle? Okay, stylohyoid ligament, stylopharyngeus muscle, glossopharyngeal nerve, second part of the lingual artery, and then genioglossus muscle. Regarding the nerve supply of the tongue has motor and sensory nerve supply. Regarding the motor nerve supply, all the muscles of the tongue are supplied by the hypoglossal nerve, except palatoglossus muscle, which is supplied by the vagus nerve through the pharyngeal plexus. Okay, sensory nerve supply, anterior 2/3, posterior 1/3, and the most posterior part of the tongue. Anterior 2/3 of the tongue, general sensation from the lingual nerve, and the taste sensation from the corda tympani branch of the facial nerve. Regarding the posterior one-third, it is supplied by the glossopharyngeal nerve, general sensation, and the taste sensation. Regarding the most posterior part of the tongue, it is supplied by the vagus nerve, it is supplied by the internal laryngeal branch of the vagus. Regarding lymph drainage of the tongue, lymph drainage of the tongue, talk about the tip of the tongue. The tip of the tongue drains into the submental lymph nodes, and the submental lymph nodes drain into the submandibular lymph nodes. So the tip, submental lymph nodes, then anterior two thirds of the tongue. The anterior two thirds of the tongue drain into the submandibular lymph nodes. The central part of the tongue, central part, drains bilaterally into the submandibular lymph nodes, and the peripheral part drains ipsilaterally into the submandibular lymph nodes. So the anterior two thirds of the tongue drain into the submandibular lymph nodes, the central part drains bilaterally, the peripheral part drains unilaterally. Then the posterior one third of the tongue, the posterior one third of the tongue drains into the upper deep cervical lymph nodes. And thank you very much, best wishes, and good luck.